Yes.
Yes,
Okay. So today we are starting new topic and very important topic for your short term as well as long term goal, that is injury, introduction and abrasion. So first we'll see the definition of injury. Injury is defined clinically as well as legally. Clinically, injury is disruption of the anatomical continuity of any tissue of the body. That is clinical definition of the injury. But as you know that our subject is also concerned with the legal aspect. So, in examination as well as a forensic medicine subject student, you should know the legal definition of the injury. So, injury, according to the 44 IPC, is defined as any harm whatsoever illegally caused to any person in body, mind, reputation and property. Are you getting the difference between the clinical definition of the injury and the legal definition of the injury? So clinically it is only the disruption of the anatomical continuity of any tissues of the body. But the legal definition of the injury is that according to the 44 IPC. So viva question, maybe what is 44 IPC? Then you should able to tell that, sir, it defines the injury in a legal means. And what is the definition of injury? Definition of the injury is, injury is defined as any harm whatever illegally caused to person, body, mind, reputation and the property. So that is very important thing. I have underlined the word illegal. Why? Because as a sir doctor, as a surgeon, or as a medical practitioner, there are some circumstances you have to take the incision in the body of the patient. So does it come under the definition of the injury? What's your opinion? Does it come under the definition of the injury? Please mute all of you. Mute all of you. So, as a surgeon or medical practitioner, you take the incision on the body, but it doesn't come under the definition of the injury. Why? Because it is legal. Why legal? Because prior doing any operation or any procedure on a patient, you take a consent. What is consent? You have written the answer as well as in our lectures of a consent I have explained. So the incision taken by a surgeon or medical practitioner doesn't come under the definition of the injury. Why? Because it is legal. Why it is legal? Because it has taken after the proper consent of the patient. So it has taken proper the proper consent of the patient. That's why it is legal. And what is the definition of the injury according to the 44 IPC? It is defined as any harm whatever illegally caused to the person, body, mind, reputation and property. So these four words are very important. Again I am repeating, illegal word is very important. Why illegal word is very important? Because you have to differentiate between the incision taken by a surgeon and any incision taken by other person. Because incision taken by a person, surgeon is the legal, because it has taken after the proper consent of the patient. So it is legal. And these 4 hours are important, that according to the 44 IPC, injury is defined as any harm, whatever illegally caused to person, what? Body, mind, reputation and property. These 4 things are very important. Body, mind, reputation and property. I am repeating, and my since last 15 years experience that I have repeated the definition of the injury many times, but in a viva student always forget this word illegally. That's why I have make it underline and in a other color. It's a very important word in a definition of the injury. That is, it is anyhow illegally caused to persons where not only body, also in a mind, also in his reputation and property. But we are not going to consider in detail about the mind, reputation or property, because they are the legal term. As a doctor, we are more concerned with the body, so we are concentrating on whatever the harm caused to the body. Is it clear? So that is the important thing about the definition of the injury, and this word illegal word is very important. So don't forget this word. Again, I am repeating the definition of the injury. Injury is defined as any harm, whatever illegally caused to where person's body, mind, reputation and property. So these are the 4 important things. But as a medical practitioner, we are going to concentrate on a body harm. Is it clear? Is it clear definition of the injury? Definition of the injury is that any harm, whatever caused illegally, I am repeating this word again, illegally to the person in a body, mind, reputation and property. Is it clear? Next. Another word is the wound. Wound medico-legally include any lesion, external or internal, caused by violence with or without breach of continuity of the skin. So many times what happens, there is the injury externally, but there is nothing is seen, but there is the internal injury. Especially it happens when injury occurs on the abdomen. So these organs like spleen and liver are the superficial one, and that skin is the, it's not, it is the relaxed. So what happens if you give some punch, there is nothing seen on a skin, but the injury is seen internally on a liver or the spleen. That can be seen in a live patient in sonography or CT scan, that there is a contusion or whatever the injury on a internal organs. So there is no need that there should be a breach of continuity in the skin. So medico-legally include any lesion, external or internal, caused by the violence with or without breach of continuity of the skin. So that is the meaning of the wound. Usually you should concentrate on a definition of the injury. So what is definition of the injury? Again, I am repeating that it is defined as under the 44 IPC as any harm, whatever illegally caused to any person in body, mind, reputation and property. Second, wound. What is medico-legal definition of the wound? That the medico-legally it include any lesion, external or internal, caused by a violence with or without disruption or continuity of the skin. That is wound. So mechanical injury. We are going to concentrate on a mechanical injury more. So are those which are caused by the physical violence to the body, depending upon the manner and how they are caused. So these are the type of the weapon you are going to learn in a one practical, how to write a weapon certificate. So there is the different forces. Blunt force is by blunt weapon. Sharp force by used by sharp weapon. Blunt weapon are stone or glass or rough surface. These are the blunt weapon. Sharp weapon are like knife, sword, like these are the sharp weapon and firearm injury are different guns like a rifle firearm, revolver, pistol. These are the different types of the firearm. We are going to learn each and every injury in detail during the further lecture series. Now only consider or concentrate on definition of the injury. What is the definition or understanding about the wound? What are the classification of the injury? So classification of the injury are first broadly classified according to their causative agent. So according to their causative agent is again classified into mechanical injury, into thermal injury, into chemical injury and miscellaneous injury. So first we learn about the mechanical injury. Mechanical injuries by blunt force are abrasion, contusion, laceration, and sharp force are incised wound, stab wound, chop wound, and fractures and the firearm injury. So you remember what are the types of the mechanical injury? The abrasion, contusion, laceration, these are caused by blunt force or blunt weapon. And next injuries are the caused by the sharp weapon. These are incised wound, stab wound, chop wound, fractures and firearm injuries. Are you understood? So abrasion, contusion, laceration, incised wound, stab wound, chop wound, fractures, firearm injury. In Marathi, abrasion is ghasra basne, nak lagne, that is abrasion. Contusion, kala nila hone, mukha mar lagne, that is contusion. Laceration, skin phatne, that is laceration. Incised wound is the chirne, kapne, that is incised wound. Stab wound is bosakne. Chop wound is type of a incised wound but with a heavy weapon like a sword or that of axe. This causes the chop wound, chopping. So here what is the difference between incised wound and chop wound? Incised wound is caused by a sharp weapon but it is light in weight, while chop wound is caused by the sharpest weapon but of a heavy weight like a sword or that of the axe. Then fractures and firearm injury. So remember this again, viva question. What are the types of the mechanical injury? Abrasion, contusion, laceration caused by hard and blunt force. Incised wound, stab wound and chop wound caused by the sharp edged weapon, light or heavy. Then fractures and firearm injury. That is according to the causative agent, and first is mechanical injury. Then thermal injury due to cold or the frostbite, trench foot, immersion foot. Many times you may have seen on a television those our soldiers for Siachen and other cold areas working, they has this frostbite, trench foot, immersion foot. And these are due to the cold. And injuries due to heat are the burns. Burns is due to dry heat and scalds are due to wet heat. So the first is classification of the injury broadly according to the causative agent. Again according to the causative agent are mechanical injury. In mechanical injury we have seen abrasion, contusion, laceration, incised wound, stab wound, chop wound, firearm, fracture. Thermal injuries due to cold are the frostbite, trench foot, immersion foot. Due to heat are the burns. Burns are due to dry heat. Scalds are due to the wet heat. Third, chemical injury again reclassified into corrosion. Corrosion is due to strong acid and alkali, and irritation is due to the mild acid and alkali. Then miscellaneous injuries are the electricity injury, lightning injury, X-ray injury, radioactive substances. So this classification is according to the causative agent. So I am again repeating this about the classification of the injury. There is question, full question comes in university or other your examination. Define injury, classify injury and write in detail about any injury like abrasion, contusion, laceration, like this full question comes. So the your first answer definition, you should always write the legal definition. Don't write the clinical definition or definition of the wound. whenever it is asked in viva as well as in a theory, you have to write the definition of the injury in a, according to the 44 IPC. What is that? 44 IPC said that injury is defined as any harm illegally caused to person, body, mind, reputation and property. Then classification of the injury. Classification of the injury first is the broadly classified according to the causative agent. In a causative agent is the mechanical injury. In a mechanical injury, abrasion, contusion, laceration, incise wound, stab wound, chop wound, fracture, firearm injury. Then the thermal injury. Again subdivided, cold and hot, heat. The cold is the immersion foot, trench foot and frostbite. While that of the heat is due, dry heat causes burns. Then the wet heat causes scalds. Then chemical injury, third type. There may be corrosion. Corrosion is caused by a strong acid and alkali. While irritation is caused by a mild acid and alkali. And miscellaneous are the electricity injury, lightning injury, X-ray injury, radioactivity. Then second broad classification is medico-legal classification. That is homicidal injury, accidental injury, suicidal injury, defense wound, fabricated wound. So these are the medico-legal classification. Third, injury in relation to death. These are antemortem injury and postmortem injury. And again, legal classification, simple injury and the grievous injury. So again, I am revising the definition. Definition is injury according to the 44 IPC defined as any harm whatsoever illegally caused to person, body, mind, reputation and property. Classification of the injury is according to the causative agent. According to the causative agent, again subclassified into the mechanical injury. Mechanical injury, again subclassification, abrasion, contusion, laceration, incise wound, stab wound, firearm wound, fractures, chop wound, etc. That is mechanical injury. Second, these are caused by a thermal injury. Again, heat and cold. Heat and cold, that is frostbite, trench foot, immersion foot. Due to heat, burns and scald. Then chemical injury. Corrosion, irritation. Miscellaneous injury. Electricity, lightning, excess radioactive substance. These up to D comes under which classification? According to the causative agent. Understood? Second classification is medico-legal classification. That is suicidal, homicidal, accidental, defense wound and the fabricated wound. Second, injuries in relation to death. Antemortem, that is before death. Those injuries, that is known as antemortem, and after death, whatever injuries are sustained is known as a postmortem. Legal classification is very important. As a doctor, after this, you have to again learn how to give the injury report. So what is the difference? Which injury is caused a simple injury? Which injury is caused a grievous injury? What is this important? In one sentence I am telling. Afterwards I am taking one lecture on how to differentiate between the simple injury and a grievous injury. What is important? Because as a doctor, the police officer brings after any quarrel or any mishap or whatever the thing, the patient to you, and you have to give the injury report, and in that you have to write either it is simple injury or it is a grievous injury. If you write it is a simple injury, then the maximum punishment is 3 years. But if you write in an opinion that it is a grievous injury, then the punishment to the accused ranges from a 3 years up to life imprisonment. So you should know the importance of giving or the report as a simple injury or grievous injury. Why? Because on your report only the police officer is going to apply the section, that is 320 IPC is for the grievous injury. If you have written grievous injury in a loose language or local language, grievous injury is called as a half murder. So if you have written grievous injury, that accused can go to the imprisonment up to life. So it's on your report. And when you are confident to give, is it simple or grievous injury? Then this lecture series will help you to differentiate which is simple injury and which is grievous injury. And what is its legal importance? I have already told. Legal importance is that on your report, police officer is going to apply the section. And afterwards, the judge is going to give the punishment to the accused on your report only. So the punishment for a simple injury is only up to 3 years. And punishment for a grievous injury ranges from 3 years up to the life imprisonment. So you should have proper knowledge how to differentiate. Is it simple injury or is it grievous injury? So these lecture series are very important. So you should attend all these lectures. And those who are not able to attend, now I am going to put it on YouTube. Afterwards, you can observe these lectures. So up till now, clear? Can I proceed? Now, sir, after this, we are going to learn each mechanical injury in detail. So the first mechanical injury is the abrasion. Abrasion definition, an abrasion is a type of a mechanical injury characterized by loss of superficial layer of skin or mucous membrane due to application of mechanical force. So it's the superficial type of the injury, and usually it involves only epidermis. So you have learnt in anatomy, in a histology lecture, what is abrasion, what is epidermis, and what are the layers of the skin. That is, the first layer is epidermis and second layer is the dermis. So the abrasion are usually are limited to the epidermis only. So pure abrasion involves only epidermis, but in many times it can involve the dermis also. So abrasion is a type of mechanical injury characterized loss of superficial layer or mucous membrane, that is dermis, due to application of the mechanical force. So abrasion is the superficial layer of skin and caused by impact of an object or weapon, or fall on a rough surface, or pressure of a fingernail, teeth, muzzle of the gun, or so it is due to the impact. The impact may be horizontal, or impact may be the tangential one. So it is the impact may be horizontal, perpendicular, or it may be tangential. So depend upon the impact, the type of the abrasion also differentiate. I will explain what are the types. So first definition, abrasion are the superficial injuries usually limited to the epidermis on the skin or a mucous membrane, usually caused by hard and blunt object. The mechanism of causing either by perpendicular force or by a tangential force. So what are the types of the abrasion? Abrasions are defined again depending upon the force, that is tangential or compression. Tangential are the linear or brush or graze abrasion. Linear abrasion is also called as a scratch abrasion. Then by compression are the pattern or non-pattern. Pattern may be due to the impact or contact. So these are the classification of the abrasion. So abrasion are usually four types, mainly scratch or linear abrasion. Second is brush or graze abrasion. Third is the impact abrasion, and fourth is the non-pressure abrasion. So now you see the picture of a linear abrasion. Can you see different linear abrasion? Linear abrasion, usually these are caused by the pointed end of a nail, pin, or that of the other pointed end, and its peculiarity is that it is wider at the beginning and it is narrower at the end. And in a pin or needle or this one, there is the heap of epithelium present at the end, not at the beginning.
beginning it is wider while narrower at the end, and at the end there is hippopipedal. Why I am explaining like this? Because if like this, then you can have a knowledge that the direction of use of a weapon as well as relative position of a victim and the accused. So for that you can give explanation to the investigating officer, and it is helpful to him for that, his further investigation. So linear abrasion is due to the pointed end of a hard and blunt object, or a pointed end of a pin, pointed end of a pin or nail, or that of the needle. So it is wider at the beginning and it is narrower at the end, and at the end there is the hippopipedal. That is linear abrasion. This is called as the graze abrasion. Graze abrasion, usually it is due to the fall on hard and blunt object and larger surface. It usually occur in accident, and you must have many times has been observed that on a fall on roadside or on a wall or on any surface, what happens, much more surface area of a body comes in a contact with the road, and so, and there is the motion also. That's why it is the larger area. This graze abrasion is also known as a brush abrasion, or it is also known as a burn abrasion. Why? Because it gives a larger area and it looks like that of a burn injury. So that is known as a, and again the it is wider the at the beginning and narrower at the end. So what is difference between the graze abrasion and linear? Linear only one. While in a graze abrasion, there the larger surface area comes in a contact, and here it is look like of a burn. So it is also known as a brush burn, and another name is the grazed abrasion. So why was question, what is the brush burn, or it MCQ comes, what is brush burn? Brush burn is a graze abrasion. When it is caused when a body comes in a contact with a larger surface area. Same thing, graze abrasion. Graze abrasion. So again, see these three pictures of a graze abrasion. This is graze abrasion. Graze abrasion. This ligature mark or a pattern abrasion. In a violent asphyxial death, you must have learned about the pattern abrasion. That is about the ligature mark. So it gives the pattern of that rope on this. So it is known as a pattern abrasion. Here in the first is usually because the it is the, due to the perpendicular. So that is pattern abrasion. And there is imprint abrasion. Imprint abrasion means that that weapon gives its imprint on that. For example, this cycle chain is there. It's not cycle chain imprint abrasion on this one. I'm giving another example. And you must have observed, if the cycle chain has the injury by the cycle chain, then you can see the cycle chain marks on a skin. So it gives the imprint of that weapon, known as the imprint abrasion. So that is about the imprint abrasion. Another example, that the previous teacher, school teacher, used to give the with a rod a punishment on the hand. So that is, it also causes the imprint. So there are two sticks. So if nowadays no one does like this, but previously our teacher used to give the punishment by this with a rod on a palm, hitting a rod on a palm or on the skin, it gives two straight lines, two straight lines. And in Marathi, it is known as a vadvatne. So that is imprint abrasion. So abrasion are broadly classified into four: linear abrasion, grazed abrasion, third is that of the patterned abrasion, and it's the imprint abrasion. Age of the abrasion, again, when it is fresh, it is reddish and no scar, no scar. After 12 to 24 hours means
within 1 day, it gives red scab. After 1 to 2 days, it gives reddish brown scab. In 3 to 5 days, it gives dark brown scab. And 5 to 7 days, blackish scab thins and falling begins from the margin. And 7 to 10 days, scab fall, leaving a hypopigmented area, absence of the infection. From this color of the scab, as a medical man, as a scientific medical man, you can give the age of since the injury. So the age of an abrasion you can give, or time since the injury, or age of the abrasion. How? And you have already observed during your the this up to this period, but you don't know the scientific thing. So if it is fresh, reddish, it is below 12 hours. If there is scab formation and scab is of a red color, then it is between 1 day, 12 hours to 24 hours. If the scab is of that is reddish brown, it is 1 to 2 days. If the scab color is dark brown, it is 3 to 5 days. If the scab color is blackish, it is 5 to 7 days. And after 7 to 10 days, scab fall, leaving hypopigmented area and absence of the. This is very important to give time since injury. So that is age of the abrasion. Antemortem, how to differentiate between antemortem abrasion and postmortem abrasion? So antemortem abrasion, reddish brown color and margins are blurred with a vital reaction. How to know vital reaction? You have to see under the microscope, and under the microscope you know, you can easily differentiate vital and non-vital reaction. So, and postmortem abrasion, yellowish in color, translucent area, margins are sharply defined, and absence of the vital reaction. These are the differentiating points between antemortem abrasion and the postmortem abrasion. Many times you get confused, then remove that part of the skin, send to the pathology department, and they can easily under the microscope differentiate. Other signs on a naked eye, that it is yellowish in color, while the antemortem abrasion depend upon is the age of the abrasion. It may be red, brown, black, like that. Translucent area, that is not present in antemortem abrasion. These margins are diffuse while there is no reaction. So in a postmortem, margins are sharp and absence of the vital. So you can easily differentiate between antemortem abrasion and postmortem abrasions. Artifact. Artifact, many times body remains for a long time, then ant may cause, or other insect, or if it is in a forest, then animal, or if it is in a water, then marine animals can cause the artifact abrasion. So artifact abrasion is also can be easily differentiated between the antemortem and between the true abrasion and the artifact abrasion by this differentiating point, that is between the antemortem abrasion and the postmortem abrasion. So with this differentiating point, you can easily differentiate that the artifact abrasion by ants, insects, animal and marine animals. So what is medical legal aspect? Medical legal aspect, that with this abrasion, you from site of impact, possibility of an internal organ injury, I have explained. If it is on abdomen, there may be the possibility injury to liver, spleen, kidney. You have to, in a live patient, you have to do USG or CT scan. With that, you can see the internal organ injury. Or if the injuries are present on a private parts of the woman, like on a breast or on a genital, then you get that there must be some other sexual sexual offense may have occurred with that female. Then with that, like imprint abrasion, with that, if there is the mark of a cycle chain, you can easily know that this is the weapon is cycle chain, or only two straight line, then it is that of a rod. So you can easily identify the object, cause of injury, why that injury has occurred, then direction of the injury. So according to I have explained that hip of epithelium, if hip of epithelium is always at the end and at the narrow, so you know the direction of the injury, that is at the beginning it is the wider, while at the end it is narrower and there is hip of epithelium. From that you can easily differentiate it is its direction of the and time of injury. So no scab within 12 hours, 12 to 10 days red scab, after that brown scab, 3 to 5 days then the dark brown scab. So then the 7 days it becomes the black scab, and 7 to scab falls, and the its heel. So again, 5 minutes are there. I will revise. That is the in today's lecture. We have seen the definition of the injury, classification of the injury, and in detail about the abrasion. So the first definition of the injury. Injury usually in a forensic medicine subject, whenever asked, you should always tell the definition of the injury. According to the 44 IPC, injury is defined as any harm whatsoever illegally caused to person, body, mind, reputation, property. And illegal word is very important. Wound is medically any lesion, external or internal, caused by the violence with or without breach of the continuity of the skin. Then classification of the wound. So the classification according to the causative agent: mechanical injury, abrasion, contusion, laceration, incisive, stab wound, chop wound, fracture, firearm injury, thermal injury due to cold, frostbite, trench foot, immersion due to heat, burn scar, chemical injury, corrosion, irritation. Miscellaneous injuries are electricity, lightning, X-rays, and radioactive. Then medico-legal classification: suicidal, homicidal, accidental, depends, and fabricated injury. Then injury according to the date, that is antemortem injury, postmortem injury. Legal classification: simple injury, grievous injury. Abrasion are a type of a superficial. Usually these are limited only up to the epidermis of skin or the mucous membrane. Pure abrasion only involves the epidermis, but most of the times dermis are also involved. Then abrasions by impact of the object, caused by impact of the object or fall on a rough surface, or pressure by finger, nails, teeth, muzzle, gun, or this one. Abrasions are again classified tangential and compression, linear, brush abrasion, pattern, and non-pattern. This is the picture of a linear abrasion, picture of a grazed abrasion, picture of a ligature mark or pattern abrasion, imprint abrasion. That the weapon imprint is there, cycle chain. Here is another weapon's imprint is there. Then age of the fresh, no scab, 12 to 25, dark red scab, 1 to 2, reddish brown scab, then dark brown scab, 3 to 5 days, 5 to 7 days, blackish scab, 7 to 10 scab, false, leaving a hypopigmented absence of the infection. Antemortem abrasion, postmortem abrasion. Reddish brown in color, margins are blurred due to alteration, while yellowish in color in postmortem, translucent area, margins are sharply defined, and absence of the vital reaction. Differentiating point between antemortem and this. Artifact of the abrasion by ant, insect, animal, and marine, with the knowledge of how to differentiate between antemortem abrasion and postmortem abrasion, you can easily differentiate between the artifacts in abrasion like ant, insect, animal, and marine. Medico-legal aspect: site of impact and possibility of internal injury. Also, the sexual offences if it is present on the private part. Identification of the object by, in case of an imprint injury, like a cycle chain or rod. Cause of injury, direction of the injury, and time since injury. Thank you very much. In next lecture, we are going to learn in detail about the contusion and possibly, if time allows, about the laceration. Thank you very much. And take care of yourself.